Hi, Java DC, and this video we are going to create RAMs in Revit. To create RAMs in Revit, go to the Architecture tab and RAMP in Circulation panel. Click on RAMP, and RAMPs are really similar to stairs, so you can learn it really easily, and they are much, much simpler in comparison with stairs. The first part is run that will create automatic RAMPs for you, and then we will have sketch RAMPs, and we will talk about the sketches in later of this video. Let's go to the run, and we have two kind of ramps. We have line or straight ramps, and we have center and arc. Okay, let's go to the top view, and let's go, for example, and use the default version of ramps in Revit. And when you create default ramps, for example, let's click once and let's click twice. You can see the length is not really a manual. And when we create a ramp in something like this, when we click on finish, when you go to 3D, we will be unsatisfied because anything doesn't work right. Because in ramps, you need to do the calculations first. Let's dive into calculations. In Revit ramp parameters, we have two main parameters, maximum incline length, and we have max slope. For example, in each slope, we have an edge between level 1 or level 2 from our departure point to our destination, and it has a h difference or height difference. We need to measure it, and also we have a maximum slope in percentage. And to calculate the maximum incline length, you need to place the h but in centimeter. For example, if it is 4 meter, you need to put it 400 centimeter, and you need to divide it by slope without any unit. And then you need to get this result and put it in here. I will write it MIL as an abbreviation. And then you need to divide this one by height or h again, but this time it should be in M unit. Let's go back to the tutorial. Now you know the logic of calculation. Let's go to ramp again. Let's go to edit type and click on duplicate, and let's put it on 15 PE, for example, for 15% of the slope. And as I said, we have two parameters in here, maximum incline length and ramp max slope. Let's bring the calculation on. Let's calculate this one. For example, the first step is you need to put the height difference between these two levels. They are 4 meter, but you need to convert it to centimeter, and you need to divide it to a slope. It will be a number, 26 by 66, and put it to maximum incline length. And then you need to divide this number, 26 by 66, by height difference, but this time in meter, 4 meter, and then you have this number, 6.665. Let's input it in here. Now, when you create your ramp this time, all of the calculation on right, and it will calculate the length of your ramp automatically. For example, let's create a ramp in this part. Let's start it from here, and let's end it in here. Let's click on finish. Now, when you see it, let's delete the rails. You can see our ramps achieved to the place that we want, and it is a sign that we've done the calculations right. And then you can copy it in another level really easily with computer clipboard and align to selected levels. Let's go to modify again and select align to selected levels, and let's select 226. And now we have our ramps in here. So that was the way we can create a one-way ramp. Now let's go and create two-way ramp, and also we want to adjust the width of ramp too. Let's go to the architecture tab and let's go to ramp again. And this time, before creating our ramps, let's go to width and let's put it on 5 meter. And let's create a two-way ramp, one way to go and one way back. Because we have 26.66 meter of ramp, we can divide it by two. It will be 13 meter 0.33. Okay, let's go one way and let's put it on 13 meter 0.33, and now let's create another run for return in this side. As I said, the ramps are really similar to stairs, so it will create the landings automatically for you. Okay, now click on finish and let's see it. And you can see the ramps in here with land. There is a tip here: in ramps, we don't have any flip option. To flip it, you need to mirror it manually, so you don't have any flip option in here. You can do the exact things for three-way and four-way ramps with this method. Now it's time to create the ramps for our spiral ramps. In spiral ramps, you need to go to the ramp again, and in here, click on center and arc, specify the center of it, and then specify the radius, and then you can specify how much of this run you want to create. For example, let's put it something like in here. Again, let's go to the center of it. Press SC to have the center of this part. If you don't have it, you have to create a model line beforehand. But for example, let's create in here and let's bring it to the center of this. And now let's create our continuation of the first ramp. And now we have a landing in here. Click on finish. And now let's go to 3D. You can see the results are okay with us, but sometimes when you don't have any calculations, you will encounter with some stupid results. So now let's dive into spiral ramps calculations. But in a spiral ramp, there are some differences. For example, we have level 0 and level 4 in here. We don't have a straight line, we have a spiral ramp. And we need to measure the arc length of the middle axis, and it will be our maximum incline. So if you've calculated the maximum incline is 26 meter, you need to make sure that your middle arc length, middle axis of your spiral ramp should be equal to maximum incline. Otherwise, it won't reach to the exact point that you want, or it will manipulate the slope and your slope is not the thing that you've calculated. Now, after understanding the logic of spiral calculation, let's go to the ramp again. Now, as I said, the center axis of the ramp and the arc length of that is our ramp length. So that dimension should be 26.66 by our calculations. For example, let's go to the arc length again, and let's create a ramp in this time. Now, for example, let's assign a really small radius, and let's see the results this time. And let's go to the annotation, or press the I for annotation, and go to the arc length, and let's see the arc length of this part. You can see it is 23 meters, so it doesn't meet our needs, but let's click on finish and let's see the results. It is working because Revit will change the slope for this part. We want 15% of the slope, so we can say we need to do the calculations and creating of spiral ramps manually most of the time to meet our needs. We'll discuss it later of this video. Maybe you are asking how we can create some customized shape. For example, we have automatic ramps, we have a straight end, we have center and so on ramp. But what happens when we want to create something like this or this? You can see here, that's way sketch comes in, and we can use a sketch. Let's go. Now we have another way to create ramps, as I said, sketch for customized shape of ramps. For example, let's bring back anything is hidden. Let's list this part. Let's go to top view and let's go to ramp, and in here we have boundary and riser. As I said in the series video 2, we have boundary for the boundary of our ramp, and we use a riser lines for any beginning and the ending, and beginning and ending of the ramp, and also beginning and ending of our landings. Okay, so that's really simple. Let's click on boundary. As I said, according to our calculation, we need 26.66 length of ramp. So to do that, let's create a 13.33 for our first run, and let's create another run for the return by the exact number. And then let's go to the boundary and let's create our, for example, sketch ramp by something like this. And let's bring it down Maybe let's put it on this join. And let's mirror it. Let's mirror it and copy it at the same time. Now we have our boundary. We want to create some risers in here. Let's go to the riser and let's fill this void, fill this gap. And now we need some landings. Because we are using a sketch, I want to create a landing in this part. Let's go to the boundary and let's create another arc at this part, something like this. And we need to fill this gap with the boundary line, not risers. And now we have our ramps. Because we don't have any stair pass in ramps, we need to mirror or move it afterwards, and we can't specify the exact bottom and top of the ramp in here. For example, let me change this part to maybe something else. Now we have our landing. Let's click on finish. Now you have your ramp with a customized shape in here without any problem with the dimensions. You can do it in spiral ramps too. Let's create another spiral ramp too with the exact numbers. Let's click on boundary and let's create an arc in here. For example, something like this. And let's go to the dimensions and let's measure this arc length. As you can see, this is about 44 meter. You can select your arc and now you can adjust the length of it to 26.66. Now we have our center of our or center axis of our ramp, and now you can move it. For example, let's move it in here. Okay, we don't want the dimensions, and now let's create some offset from it. Because this is the center of our ramps, we need to create our offsets in each way. Let's put it on, let's go to the peak line and let's put it on maybe 2 meter, this side and this side. Now you need to fill these gaps with risers, and we don't need any middle axis anymore. And you can see, don't connect these two ends with perpendicular line because it will ruin the calculation. Just do it something like this, and then you can rotate it really easily to make it perpendicular or align with your face, something like this, and let's move it. And now we have our ramps in here. Let's click on finish and see the results. Beautiful, really beautiful. And now you can create these sketch ramps as you need, because now you know the standards and you know the calculations. And the next thing you need to know about the ramps in Revit, you need to subscribe and smash that like button too to make sure they work. As you may have understand, the ramps that we've modeled so far are the ramps with thicknesses, and we don't have any solid or filled ramps. But sometimes we have some ramps that will be formed by a solid shape. It will be filled by some materials in here. Let's see how we can create these kind of ramps in Revit. As I said, sometimes we need a solid ramp to do that, because sometimes we fill under the ramps with some other materials. To do that, let's click on edit type and put the shape from the thickness. You can change the thickness of it in here too. Let's put it on solid, and it will fulfill under a ramp automatically by Revit. This is some types of ramp we use in some places. Let's bring it back to thickness, and we don't have any other important options except ramp material. Can change the ramp material to something else. You can see we've changed our ramp material, but there is a limitation in ramps, and we don't have any kind of layers as we had in floors, but in reality we have them. Let's see how we can solve it. Ramps have some limitation with layering. For example, in reality and in construction, we have ramps with multiple layers. So let's go in Revit and let's see how we can create multi-layer ramps in Revit. As I said, we have some limitation to overcome with it. We use floors. For example, we have our ramp in here. We use it as a base shape and we use floors at the top of it. And then we will delete the ramps. Okay, let's go to floor in here. And you can adjust the layers as you want. For example, let's select this one and pick the outer edges of your ramp. And now let's click on finish. And let's go to the modify shape, modify sub element, and let's bring it up. And then you can delete your ramp. And now you have your ramp. You can bring it a little bit upper. Now you have your ramp with layers. Let's bring it in section box. You can see the layers of your ramp with this method that we used in here. And make sure to see the stairs video in here. In that video, we will learn to model any shape of a stair you can imagine. I will see you on the next session.